जी नाउ द 10th क्लास फॉर इकोनॉमिक्स. नाउ द नेक्स्ट पेज आई एम रीडिंग दैट इज 43rd पेज. द नंबर इज 43. इंडियन मनी एंड क्रेडिट थर्ड चैप्टर. टू डिफरेंट क्रेडिट सिचुएशन. अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन इन आर डे टू डे एक्टिविटीज इन्वॉल्व क्रेडिट इन सम फॉर्म और द अदर एंड क्रेडिट रेफर्स टू एन एग्रीमेंट इन विच द लेंडर सप्लाई द बोरोअर विद मनी. सो देर इज अ एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन द सप्लाई ऑफ द मनी एंड द बोरोअर and goods and services in return for the promise of future payment. Let us see how credit works through the following two examples. So there are two examples are there. That is basically with the the people are very poor in the country and farmers are very poor in the country and we are living in the rural area. Most of the people living in the rural area, so it's very difficult for them to get loan easily whenever they are in severe need of finance. It is not easy with the people like us who are having a good financial position. We are having a lots of asset with us and then we are living in the urban area. We are having lots of bank around us, so we are not facing the situation. But the people in country, they are facing the this particular problem with them. So that is why they are discussing in the same very way. So first festival season, first of all, this is a situation. That is with the, it is a festival season 2 months from now and the shoe manufacturer Salim has received an order for a large order trade in the town for 3,000 pair of shoes to be delivered in a month time. I'm also translating this also. I have to translate that Salim is a shoe manufacturer and he is having an order that is a large order of 3,000 pair he has to make. That is to be delivered within a month. To complete production on time, Salim has to hire a few more workers for stitching, pasting work. He has to purchase the raw material. To meet these expenses, Salim obtained loan from two sources. First, he asked the leather supplier to supply leather on credit now and promise to pay him later. So he is, he's saying to the, who is saying? Salim is saying to the supplier that please supply me leather. So that when I will make the goods and sell the goods, then I will repay your money. So he want that supplier will supply the leather on credit. Now, second, another way, he obtained loan in cash from the large trader as advance payment for 1,000 pair of shoes with the promise to deliver the whole order by the end of the time. So he requested two people. First, the supplier of leather, that is raw material, that supply leather to me and I will make the payment after the selling of shoes. And then he's taking the loan from the large trader who has given him order. He said that please give me the advance of 1,000 pair and I will deliver the shoes on time. At the end of the month, Salim is able to deliver the order and make a good profit and repay the money that he had borrowed. So both the party was agreed. Now Salim was happy because he is able to deliver the order and make profit out of it. So this is the situation with a trader. Fine. In this case, now this is the observation. In this case, Salim obtains credit to meet the working capital needs of production. The credit helps him to meet the ongoing expenses of production, complete production on time, and thereby the increase his earning. Credit therefore plays a vital role and positive role in the situation. So what is the importance of credit? It is used to be said that only spend the money which you are having. Don't borrow from here and there for your consumption expenditure. So that has been always suggestion for the people that don't borrow. Fine. So here Salim is taking loan and he is getting profit. So here he is proving that credit is a very important role for making profit or for the smooth running of the business. So here the word is given working capital. Working capital means day-to-day activities, expenses for day-to-day activities. So that is the working capital. If you require finance for day-to-day activities of the business, that is working capital. That money is known as working capital. There is one more question can arise for you, that what is working capital and how, give an example how credit plays a very vital and positive role in the situation or for the business. Now there is another problem, Swapna's problem. Swapna, a small farmer, grows groundnut on her 3 acres of land. She takes a loan from the money lender to meet the expenses of cultivation. Now she used to take the loan from money lender. Money lender are informal source of credit, giving credit. So this is, she is using the informal source of credit, hoping that her harvest would get repay the loan. Midway through the season, the crop is hit by pest and the crop fails. Now, she has taken loan from the money lender, but her crop has been failed. Now, what happened? Though Swapna spray her crops with expensive pesticide, it makes little difference. She is unable to repay the money lender and the debt grows over the year into a large amount. So, because she is not having the good crops that you are saying, as you are saying that, you know, she seems to be very poor and a whole crop has been fallen. So, that is why she is not able to pay back the money to money lender. And debt grows, debt used to grow over the year into a large amount. Because interest was there, that was in the circulation on the principal amount, then again on the principal amount. Next year, Swapna takes a fresh loan for cultivation. It is a normal crop for this year. But the earning are not enough to cover the old loan and she is caught in debt and she has to sell a part of the land to pay off the debt. So here the situation of getting credit. So this is a very good situation, very fruitful for Saleem when things goes well. But when thing doesn't go well, then this credit became a very bad situation for the people who are borrowing money from here and there. Because she was not able to cope up with the profit she is earning to pay the loan. So this was the problem with Swapna. Now they are discussing that in rural areas, the main demand for credit is for crop production. So that one more question can ask that in rural area, what is the main demand? Why there is a main demand for credit? What was the reason why people demand for credit? That is for crop production. Crop production involves considerable cost on seeds, fertilizer, pesticide, water, electricity, repair of equipment, all these activities which involves money. Due to that, the farmer asks for money, asks for credit. There is a minimum stretch of 3 to 4 months between the time when the farmer buy these inputs and when they sell the crop. So they are not having much of the time. They cannot postpone their they cannot postpone their demand because there is a stretch of 3 to 4 months for growing a good crops. So that is why farmer was in sore need of getting this money for all these activities. Farmers usually take crop loan at the beginning of the season and repay the loan after harvest. Repayment of the loan is crucially dependent on the income from farming, and which is a very you can say vulnerable situation for the farmer. When their crops does not go well, then they are caught in the debt trap. Like in the Swapna case, as you are saying just now, Swapna case, the failure of the crop made loan repayment impossible. So she had to sell part of the land to repay the loan. So credit, instead of helping Swapna improve her earning, left her worse off. So this can be the worst situation when the credit does not go well, and credit proves to be the worst situation. That makes a worse situation for Swapna. This is the example of what the commonly called debt trap. Credit in this case pushes the borrower into a situation from which recovery is very painful. So that is what do you mean by the debt trap? One question arises from this paragraph. What is debt trap? Debt trap means when first the loan has been taken and the borrower is not able to pay back the loan due to some problem, and now for paying the first loan he has again borrowed amount for the second time to pay back the loan taken from the first. Then out of the second also he is not getting the profit from the activities and he has to take a loan, and then now he is taking loan for the third time. Now he is in the debt trap because he is taking loan from this or that way for paying of the loan of the previous to all the previous loan and interest. So he will be in the debt trap. In one situation, credit helps to increase earning and therefore the person is better off than before, like in the case of Saleem. In another situation, because of the crop failure, credit pushes the person into a debt trap. To repay her loan, she has to sell a portion of land. You have to sell your asset in that case, or you have to take loan from other this or that side to pay back your previous loan. So she is clearly much worse off. Who is she? She is Swapna. Swapna is clearly much worse off than before. Pehle se bhi buri halat mein chali gayi wo. Whether credit would be useful or not, therefore depend on the risk in the situation, whether there is some support in case of loss. Now, Swapna was in need of support from some government authority in this case. So that is why it has been pointed out over there, because it used to happen with many farmers. Now, terms of credit we are discussing. Every loan agreement specify an interest rate which the borrower must pay to the lender along with the repayment of the principal amount. So that is the interest is must over there. In addition, lender may demand collateral security against loan. Security means collateral is basically kya hai? That is an asset that the borrower owns, like it can be in the form of land, building, vehicle, livestock, deposit with the bank or some other, or uses this as a guarantee to lender until the loan is repaid. So you have to keep some asset with the bank. वो कहते हैं ना पैसा भी पैसा देकर ही मिलता है बैंक से. सो यू हैव टू कीप सम एसेट विद द बैंक एंड देन बैंक विल गिव यू लोन. इन दिस केस कोलैटरल सिक्योरिटी इज मस्ट इन द बैंक, स्पेशली इन नेशनलाइज्ड बैंक. इफ यू आर सेइंग दैट इन प्राइवेट बैंक, या इन प्राइवेट बैंक देर आर सम एग्जम्पशन, ओके दे आर टेकिंग द रिस्क, बट इन नेशनलाइज्ड बैंक दिस कोलैटरल सिक्योरिटी इज नेसेसरी, इज मस्ट. कोलेटरल सिक्योरिटी का मतलब आप कोई भी एसेट रखो बैंक के पास, फिर बैंक वो सपोज़ करो आपने सपोज़ करो 1 लाख का लोन लेना, तो बैंक आपको बताएगा कि कितने रुपए की सिक्योरिटी आपको, कितने रुपए की एसेट आपको बैंक के पास मिनिमम रखनी होगी इफ़ यू वांट लोन फ्रॉम द बैंक. नाउ इफ द बोरोवर फेल्स टू पे द लोन, द लेंडर हैज़ राइट टू सेल द प्रॉपर्टी और द कोलेटरल टू ऑब्टेन पेमेंट. सो दिस इज द सिचुएशन व्हेन बोरोवर इज नॉट एबल टू पे द लोन, देन लेंडर हैज़ अ राइट टू सेल द एसेट और कोलेटरल टू ऑब्टेन पेमेंट. Property such as land titles, deposit with bank, these type of property can be kept as a collateral security. Land titles, deposit with bank, livestock or some common example of collateral used for borrowing. Now I'm the next page, that is page number 45. Interest rate, collateral and documentation requirement and the mode of repayment together comprise what is called the terms of credit. This is very important question. What do you mean by the terms of credit? All these are the particulars of terms of credit. Terms of credit का मतलब कि क्या condition आपस में fix हुई है borrower के बीच में और lender के बीच में. That is the terms of credit. Interest rate, you know, that is interest on loan. Collateral security means the security which you have to keep with the bank as your security, so that bank can give you loan. And documentation requirement. What are the documents and what are the paperwork you have to do? Like a loan agreement that is to be written on the paper, and the mode of payment, how you will repay the loan. So that all everything is written over there. The terms of credit vary substantially from one credit arrangement to another. Don't think that all the terms of credit are same. They can be vary from one to another. They may vary depending on the nature of the lender and the borrower. Next section will provide example on the varying terms of credit in different credit arrangements. This is the list of terms of credit that is given over there. Meghna's housing loan. Meghna has taken a loan of 5 lakhs above is given over there from the bank to purchase a house. The annual interest on the loan is 12% and loan is to be repaid in 10 years in the monthly installment. And Meghna had to submit to the bank a document showing her employment and record and salary before the bank agreed to give her loan. Suppose you are a salaried person, then you have to submit your salary statement over there for taking loan from the bank. The bank retained as a collateral the paper of the new house. So the paper of this house is to be kept by bank as a collateral security, which will be returned to Meghna only when she repays the entire loan with the interest. So loan amount you have to fill. So these are the terms of credit. This type of question can come, new type of question, they can come in your paper way. Even loan amount is 5 lakh, you have to fill all the particulars are given over there in this story. Duration of loan, that is 10 year. Documents required over there, that her employment record, salary, then the papers of this particular house, they are the documentation, and interest rate that is to be charged. Annual interest rate on the loan is 12%. Mode of repayment. Repayment is to be done monthly installment within 10 years. Collateral is the paper of this new house. So this is the collateral security over there. So all these particulars you have to fill. Suppose this story comes in your exam. Okay. Here the questions are written. Why do lender ask for collateral while lending? So why lender ask for collateral? Because in case if the borrower is not able to pay back the money, then lender will use his collateral security and sell that particular asset or collateral security to obtain the payment. Now, given that a large amount of people in our country are poor, And does it in any way affect their capacity to borrow? Yes, it definitely affect their capacity to borrow, because they are, many of the people are not having even collateral security. If you are with shortage of fund and not having any wealth or asset, then it is not possible for you to take loan. Fine, so it is not possible for the people in India who are very poor to take loan, because they cannot have the collateral security. Now third, fill in the blanks, choosing the correct option from the brackets. While taking a loan, borrower look for easy terms of credit. This means low or high interest rate, easy condition, easy or tough condition for payment. Definitely high, that is basically, while taking a loan, borrower, they want low interest rate, and then interest rate with the easy, it will be easy condition for repayment, and dash less or more collaterals and documentation, and there is a less documentation they want. Fine, these are the story which you are to read. Fine, and there is a story of Rohit and Ranjan, and then there is a Shyamlal story for taking credit, for using credit, and for collateral security. Rama is working in neighboring field, loan from cooperatives. So all these are the stories that has been taken for getting credit from here there. This is an interesting one which you have to read, and these are the simple stories of a particular person living here or there. So this is the important story which you have to read, that is loan from cooperatives. Besides bank, the other major source of cheap credit in rural areas are the cooperative societies, four cooperatives. Member of the cooperatives pool their resources for cooperation in certain areas. And there are several types of cooperative possible, such as farmer cooperatives, weavers cooperatives, industrial workers cooperatives, etc. So these type of cooperatives are over there. They pool their money, means they collect some of the saving from each other. Ye aapas mein ek dusre ki saving collect karte hain. उसको पूल यानी कि उसको एक बड़ा अमाउंट बना के देन दे गिव लोन टू ईच अदर, अपने आप को एक दूसरे को ये लोन देते हैं, ये कोऑपरेटिव्स होती हैं. नाउ नेक्स्ट थिंग इज कृषक कोऑपरेटिव फंक्शन इन अ विलेज नॉट वेरी फार अवे फ्रॉम सोनपुर. ये एक सोनपुर सिटी है, एक डिस्ट्रिक्ट है बेसिकली, जहाँ से ये कोऑपरेटिव फंक्शंस वर्क करती हैं. इट हैज़ 2300 फार्मर्स एज मेंबर. एक बात कर रहा है, ये कृषक कोऑपरेटिव है, ये इसमें 2300 फार्मर्स हैं. 2300 फार्मर्स हैं तो उनकी सेविंग भी बहुत होगी, तो एक अच्छा अमाउंट ये कलेक्ट कर लेंगे एक दूसरे से. देन दे विल गिव लोन टू ईच अदर. इट एक्सेप्ट डिपॉजिट फ्रॉम इट्स मेंबर विद दीज डिपॉजिट एज अ कोलेटरल. द कोऑपरेटिव्स हैज़ ऑब्टेन्ड अ लार्ज लोन फ्रॉम द बैंक. समटाइम दे कीप दिस पर्टिकुलर यू नो सेविंग फ्रॉम ईच अदर. ये बहुत आपका बहुत बड़ा अमाउंट हो जाता है, देन दिस बिग अमाउंट दे विल कीप इन द बैंक फॉर गेटिंग लोन फ्रॉम द बैंक. And these funds are used to provide loan to member. Once these loans are repaid, another round of lending can take place. So basically, ये कर क्या रहे हैं, ये यहाँ पर ये भी करते हैं. देखो बहुत small level पर तो ये आपस में पैसा pool करके एक दूसरे को देते हैं. Otherwise, जो ये पैसा pool करते हैं, जो एक दूसरे को saving collect करते हैं, suppose करो 2300 farmers हैं. 2300 farmers को बोला जाता है कि आप अगर 500 rupees अपनी जो भी आपका earning है, 2300 farmers से बोला जाता है कि आप 500 rupees भी दे दो, तो आपके पास ये बेसिकली हो जाता है 11,50,000. तो ये जो अमाउंट हो जाता है, इसको ये एज अ कोलेटरल सिक्योरिटी बैंक में रखते हैं, देन दे कैन टेक लोन फ्रॉम द बैंक. 11,50,000 अगर आप रखते हो बैंक में, तो उस केस में आपको बहुत ज़्यादा लोन मिल जाएगा, ठीक है ना. कोलेटरल सिक्योरिटी से आपको कुछ परसेंटेज होता है, बैंक बता देगा आपको कि भाई आप इतना लोन ले सकते हो, ठीक है. नेक्स्ट, कृषक कोऑपरेटिव, ये एक बहुत सक्सेसफुल कोऑपरेटिव है जिसके बारे में बात हो रही है. प्रोवाइड लोन फॉर द परचेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इम्प्लीमेंट्स, लोन फॉर कल्टीवेशन, एग्रीकल्चर ट्रेड. तो दी एग्रीकल्चर कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी है, तो दे आर प्रोवाइडिंग लोन फॉर सच थिंग्स. फिशरीज लोन, लोन फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ हाउसेज एंड फॉर वैरायटी ऑफ अदर एक्सपेंसेस. जब ये कोऑपरेटिव बनती हैं, देन दैट हैज़ बीन रिटन इन द पेपर वर्क दैट इन द पेपर दैट दे कैन गिव लोन फॉर हाउ मेनी एक्टिविटीज और फॉर विच पर्पजेज. फाइन, तो दिस इज द लोन फ्रॉम कोऑपरेटिव्स एंड दैट्स हाउ दे वर्क, ठीक है. Now next thing is formal sector credit in India. We have seen in the above example that people obtain loan from various sources. The various type of loan can be conveniently grouped as formal sector loan and informal sector loan. So taking loan from the sources can be divided on two categories. into two categories. First is formal sector loan, another is informal sector loan. Among the former are loans from bank and cooperative. What are the formal sector loan? That is the bank and cooperatives. And what is the informal sector loan? That is, informal sector loan includes informal lenders, includes money lender, trader, employer, relatives, friends, neighborhood. So all these people comes under informal sector loan. In graph 1, you can see the various source of credit to rural household in India. Is more credit coming from the formal sector or the informal sector? So there, the pie diagram is given over there. Source of credit per rupees 1000 of rural households in India in 2012. So this is the pie diagram related of household, particular year 2012. So rural area means village area. So there is a, this particular portion shows that cooperative societies, bank, 25% portion, 25% loan comes from cooperative society, commercial banks 25%, and then other institution agencies 5%, and then here is a landlord 1%, money lender 33%, relatives and friends 8%, and other institutional sector 2%, and the government side the loan can be the 1%. So the maximum part coming from the cooperative society, commercial bank, and then money lender, they all are there having the major portion. So the maximum they got from the money lender. So these are the money lender who have their own terms and condition. It is the informal source of credit using in the rural area as per 2012 data. So this is the actual data related to 2012. So now the percentage has been increased. 25% is not a bad. Cooperative society 25%, but more should be from bank side because it has a fair terms and condition and less exploitation of the farmer. But farmer also blaming that bank is exploiting them. There is a blame for commercial banks also. The money lenders are there, 33% for money lenders. Fine. So after observing this pie diagram, now the next thing is Reserve Bank of India supervises the functioning of formal source of loan. So which authority of India supervising the functioning of formal source of loan? That is Reserve Bank of India. For instance, means for example, we have seen that bank maintain a minimum cash balance, as you have just read about that. Minimum cash balance means percentage of deposit they have to keep as a minimum cash balance out of the deposit they receive, and the RBI monitor the bank and actually maintaining cash balance. RBI has to look after that. Percentage of deposit must be kept by commercial bank itself, and RBI has to monitor it. Similarly, the RBI sees that the bank give loan not just to profit making businessman and trader, but also to small cultivators, small scale industries, and here to small borrowers, etc. Periodically, the bank have to submit information to the RBI on how much they are lending to whom, at what interest rate, etc. So this is a function of RBI, that to see that bank give loan not just to for profit making businessman, the loan must be reached to the small scale industry, farmers also, small borrower also. This bank, RBI has to see. RBI many time fix a quota that a percentage of deposit should be given to the small farmers or small businessman. Periodically means time to time bank have to submit their information to the RBI on how much they are lending to whom at what interest. So all information has to be submitted to RBI time to time. So here the question can come, how RBI regulate how much percentage of deposit is given for small scale businessman or large scale businessman or rich person. So because the information is submitting to RBI regarding this by the commercial bank time to time. There is no organization which supervises credit activities of the lender in the informal sector, and they can lend at whatever interest rate they have chosen. So there is no organization for a money lender like informal sector like to look after that at which terms of condition, which interest rate has been charged from the person who is getting the loan, who is borrowing the loan. So terms and condition between lender and the borrower, especially in the case of informal sector, there is no authority over there to supervise all these things. Now on the next page, that is page number 49. There is no one to stop them from using unfair means. No one means, no organization is there to stop the unusing mean, the unfair means used by informal sector to get the money back. They are using unfair means definitely, So compared to the formal lenders, most of the informal lenders charge a very high rate of interest, definitely. Thus, the cost to the borrower of informal loan is much higher. Fine. Higher cost of borrowing means a large part of the earning of the borrower is used to repay the loan. Hence, borrower have less income left for themselves. As we have seen in the case of Shamlar in Sonpur, that has been the story. Now I have told you that, read out all the stories. There the story of Shamlar, in the case of Shamlar. In certain cases, the high interest rate for borrowing can mean that amount to be repaid is greater than the income of the borrower. And this could lead to the increasing debt. And as we saw for Rama in Sonpur, that is a story related to that page, and debt trap. Also, people who might wish to start an enterprise by borrowing may not do so because of the high cost of borrowing. So many times people don't want to get loan or don't want to grow because they are afraid of getting into debt trap. Because when the loan has been taken and activities does not go well, profit is not there, or you know, if anything that has been failed by taking that loan, so in that case it is very difficult to pay back the loan and the person will be in debt trap. For these reason, bank and cooperative society need to lend more. This is a suggestion. This would lead to higher income. Many people could then borrow cheaply for a variety of needs. They could grow crops, do business, set up small scale industry. So that is why bank and cooperative society should come up to give more loan to small farmers, to poor people, so that they can grow. They could set up new industry, trade in goods. Cheap and affordable credit is crucial for the country's development. So this is the question that can come, that how cheap and affordable credit is crucial for the country's development. Cheap and affordable credit means there should be less interest rate and with the less harsh condition, and there will be a liberal condition of terms of credit. They should be there. Affordable credit should be there. Affordable interest rate should be there for the country's development, so that small farmers, poor people could go for loan and they will not afraid of the debt, getting into debt trap. There would always be some solution for those people who are getting into debt trap and they are very poor in this case. Fine. So that has been discussed over there. That's all for now. Next, I will read in my next video.